This is how a semi-automatic AR-15 fires. Here it is again, this time converted into pump action. The American modification, dubbed the Animus, pulls every bullet into the chamber manually and could potentially be used to work around gun laws.
AR-15s are built so that people can convert them to long-range rifles or specialty rifles, depending on what they want them for, straight out of the box. So they have an upper and a lower, and you can swap parts in and out.
With buyback events starting this weekend, many gun owners would rather modify their firearms to keep them legal.
The true value of these firearms are not being met by government. So people will be looking at other avenues of being able to retain their firearms in a legal configuration.
There is opposition though. An AR-15 was the primary weapon system used during the Christchurch terror attack.
A semi-automatic weapon that's been converted to being a pump action or a bolt action can easily be converted back again.
Police have been criticised for not clearly explaining to gun owners what modifications can be made. They're still working on it and couldn't confirm whether those AR-15 kits were legal when contacted by One News today.
The AR-15 is just one part of the discussion. Many want to convert their hunting and sporting rifles but don't know how. Christchurch gunsmith Andrew Backer says he's received at least 50 inquiries.
It's going to be your 22 bolt action rifles that have more than 10 shots, or antique lever action rifles that have more than 10 shots. They're the ones that I've been messaged about the most.
The question now is whether, with all this confusion, gun owners will stay at home when the buyback begins on Saturday. Thomas Mead, One News.